Let us analyze the phenomena of wave interference mathematically. In this section, we'll study how the resulting amplitude of two waves after interference changes. And we are also going to discuss about the factors on which the interference at a position depends. Like say, if we are having two sources S1 and S2, which are coherent, and say S1 is producing wave which is of amplitude A1 in a specific direction, and S2 is producing a wave of amplitude A2 in another direction, and at a medium particle P, the two waves will superpose. See, the point P is located at a distance x1 and x2 from the two waves. So, we can directly state if the two sources are started simultaneously, as x1 is less than x2, P will start oscillating with amplitude A1 in the influence of S1. And after some time, when the wave from S2 will also arrive at P, it will start oscillating with some new amplitude. Certainly, it will not be A2 because it was earlier oscillating with A1. So, as soon as the wave from S2 will arrive, its oscillation amplitude will be modified according to the phenomena of interference. Now, in this situation, we can say when a particle at P starts oscillating under the influence of the source S1, say that was the time t equals to 0. So, we can say at t equal to 0, particle at P starts oscillating with amplitude A1 and its displacement can be given as Y1 can be written as A1 sine of omega t. Say this is our equation 1, and we can treat omega as the angular frequency of these two sources, and as these are coherent, these must be of same frequency. Now, we are taking t equal to 0, the time when P starts oscillating under the influence of source S1. At this instant, as we know, the two waves exist in the same medium, these are traveling with same speed. So, at this instant, when first wave arrives at P, second wave would be midway, and the path difference from the point P to the second wave can be simply written as x2 minus x1. So, we can easily calculate the time lag in superposition of the two waves at P as the first wave has already arrived. So, time lag we can calculate in superposition will be delta t. It can be written as x2 minus x1 by v, if v is the speed with which the waves are propagating. So, this is the time a wave will take. Second wave will take in covering the path difference delta. Now, in this situation, when the second wave will arrive, we can say the second wave will be lagging in phase with respect to first wave at point P because it is arriving later. So, here we can write after time delta t, second wave arrives at P with a phase lag phi. This phi can be written as omega delta t. This with respect to first wave, in this situation we can write as omega multiplied by x2 minus x1 by v. And we already studied in the previous section that omega by v can be written as wave number, or it is 2 pi by lambda into x2 minus x1. Now, if this is the phase lag, we can write displacement of particle at P due to second wave is, this displacement we can write as y2. It is an independent amplitude of a particle P. Only under the influence of second wave, this can be written as A2 sine of omega t minus phi, because if we are taking t equal to 0 the time, before arrival of second wave. So, we must write its equation can be written as E2 sin of omega t minus phi. So, this is our second equation. Now, let's discuss about the superposition of these two waves at P. Now, according to principle of superposition, according to we can write superposition principle, the resulting displacement of particle at P can be given as this yp we can write as y1 plus y2 as the two waves are superposing. We just substitute their displacement equations. We can write as it is a1 sin omega t plus a2 sin of omega t minus phi. In this situation, just to sum up the two terms, we just open it trigonometrically. It will be a1 sin omega t plus a2 sin omega t cos phi minus a2 cos omega t sin phi. Always remember, whenever such trigonometric terms you'll encounter in any problem, always separate the terms of sin omega t and cos omega t separately, independently. So, this yp can be written as a1 plus a2 cos phi into sin omega t. Here I've taken the sin omega t common, and minus a2 sin phi multiplied by cos omega t. Now, in this situation, we can say a1, a2 are the two independent amplitudes and phi is the phase difference, which remains constant, will not vary with time as the waves are coherent. So, these two terms will always remain same, which does not depend on time. Here we substitute these terms as r cos theta and r sin theta to compress the expression. And here this resulting displacement of point P can be given as r sin omega t cos theta minus r cos omega t sin theta. This will be r sin of omega t minus theta. This is the final resulting displacement we are getting. We just have a look on this expression carefully. You can see this is an equation of simple harmonic motion. That means we can say after superposition, particle at P will execute SHM with amplitude R and initial phase minus theta. That means we can say when two or more coherent waves superpose on a medium particle, the resulting motion of a medium particle remains simple harmonic, but its amplitude and phase of oscillation is modified, which we can calculate by using the terms we are having. Here we have substituted r sin theta as a2 sin phi. And r cos theta we have substituted for a1 plus a2 cos phi. From these terms, if we square and add, we can simply write squaring and adding. This will give us r is equals to root of, if we just square the two terms and add, this will be a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos phi. And dividing these two terms will get the value of theta, which is 10 inverse of a2 sin phi upon a1 plus a2 cos phi. If we just have a look carefully on these two expressions, we can see these are similar to the results of parallelogram law of vector addition when two vectors a1 and a2 having the angle between them is phi. If added, the resulting vector is given by this expression, and the angle of resulting vector with the first vector can be given by this expression. So, just for ease in calculation, you can just remember that the resulting amplitude of oscillation after interference can be obtained by treating individual wave amplitude as vectors and their phase difference as angle between them. Let's analyze other cases related to interference also. As just now we have discussed that resulting amplitude and initial phase of oscillation of the particle where two coherent waves superpose, or more precisely we say when the waves interfere, then due to interference the resulting oscillation amplitude of medium particle is given by this expression and initial phase is given by this expression. Here we can see that in interference, the resulting oscillation amplitude and its initial phase depends on component wave amplitudes and the phase difference between the two waves. Like here component waves are those waves which are superposing at a medium particle and producing the phenomena of interference, which are having amplitudes A1 and A2 and the phase difference between them is phi. So on various cases of interference, mainly the resulting amplitude is useful for us. In some cases this angle is also useful, but you should always remember both of these results. And we'll soon see the various cases where the value of r and theta changes with variation in A1, A2 and phi. Let's discuss some other cases of interference.